Hey guys, Daniel from Roland, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to sequence both your Serato sampler sounds and the built-in drum sounds on your DJ-202. Let's dive right in. So as we look on our DJ-202, the first thing that we need to make sure is that we press sequencer on both sides of the controller. The reason for this is because we need all 16 pads in order to program one bar's worth of information. You'll notice that if I press sequencer on the left side, parameter minus lights up. On the right side, parameter plus lights up. So as you start to get really good at programming, you don't need to have both sides lit up. Parameter minus means you're programming steps 1 through 8. Parameter plus means you're programming steps 9 through 16. But since we're just starting out and learning how to sequence, we're going to make sure that parameter minus is selected on the left side. Parameter plus is selected on the right side. Now for the basics, I don't want to use the Serato sampler sounds. How I want to teach you first is utilizing the built-in drum sounds on the DJ-202. The DJ-202 comes preloaded with essentially 4 drum machines. And those 4 drum machines are the 808, the 909, 707, and 606. And all 4 of these drum machines have heritage in styles of dance music. And these aren't just drum samples, they're actually crafted drum sounds modeled like the actual analog circuits in the drum machines like the 808, the 909, and the 606. And you get the same drum sounds that are on the 707 as well. And the way that you select these drum machines inside of the controller is by holding shift and pressing sequencer twice. Since I did it on the left side, my sequencer button is now flashing really quickly. And I can preview whatever drum machine is loaded first on my DJ-202. So that's my 808 kit. If I'm in this mode, the way to change the drum machine is by holding shift. This first pad here signifies that I've chosen the 808. This is going to be the 909. This is the 707. And this last one here is the 606. So by holding shift and pressing sequencer twice, I am in what's called instrument play mode. And inside of instrument play, I can either just play the drums, or again, I can change the kits by holding shift and pressing one of the 4 top buttons to select the drum machine that I want. So I'm gonna go back. I like the 808 kit. It's my favorite, so I'm gonna get out of that mode by pressing sequencer once. And now again, both of these sequencer buttons are solid green. So if I wanna start sequencing the built-in drum sounds, I need to make sure that I'm in the built-in drum sound selection. And the way to do that is I make sure that my sequencer buttons are both green. They're both steady, there's no flashing lights. I'm gonna hold shift, and I need to press parameter plus. Parameter minus means that I've selected the Serato sampler. So the 8 slots from the Serato sampler that I can sequence with the sequencer, or parameter plus to sequence the built-in drum sounds. So again, since we want the built-in drum sounds, I'm going to select parameter plus. And now I can select from any of the instruments on the DJ-202. So if I want the, let's say, kick drum, I'm going to hold shift and press this very first button. So it's gonna go kick drum, snare drum, closed hi-hat, open hi-hat, low tom, hand clap, rim shot, and ride cymbal, or cowbell, depending on what kit you've chosen. So since I'm on the 808, I wanna program my kick drum first. But before I do that, look, I already have kick drums programmed because I'm editing a pre-sequenced beat. If I want to clear it, what I have to do is hold shift, press sequencer once to get into the pattern mode. I'm going to hold the parameter minus button, and you'll know that you're doing it correctly when these pads start to flash. And you can select any of these 8 patterns to delete. Since we're using the first one, just out of convenience, I'm going to clear the very first pattern. I'm going to let go of that now. My sequencer button is still flashing and I need this to be solid, so I'm going to press it one more time. And since I've already selected the kick drum, How this is gonna work is this. If I press the start stop button on the sequencer side, right over here, you're gonna see that what we call the green playhead is gonna move across all 16 of these pads. Now, what you're basically programming is essentially a one bar loop, meaning that your downbeats, 1, 2, 3, and 4, are all based here. You have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So let's say we're starting off and doing just a basic track. Kick drums are typically on beats 1 and 3. And again, I've selected these two because it goes 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm gonna now select my snare drum. So I'm gonna hold shift, press the second button to select my snare drum. And snare drums alternate. So they go on beats 2 and 4. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this is a very basic rhythm. I can add more kick drums if I wanted to give it some more bounce. So let's say I hold shift, go back to my kick drum, which is the very first pad. And now that I've added just a few more kick drum rhythms, you can really start to hear the beat start to bump a little bit. So now I'm gonna hold shift and I'm gonna go to my closed hi-hat. I'm gonna start to program my hi-hats at each downbeat. If I wanted to do what's called an eighth note beat, I would select every other pad. So now we're gonna program a hand clap. So as I hold shift and select the hand clap, I'm gonna put it just kind of arbitrarily. Then let's say we wanna layer a rim shot onto it. So that was a really simple beat. Let's say we want to program a house beat. So again, we're going to go through those same steps of programming the sounds, except this time I'm going to change to the 909 kit. So again, the way that I'm going to change the kit is by holding shift and pressing sequencer twice. And since I'm already holding shift again, I'm going to select the second pad here. And now I have my 909 drum sounds. So I'm going to click the sequencer button again without holding shift this time in order to make the button solid. It's going to have the same pattern that I built on the previous kit, but I want to delete it because I want to start fresh, right? So again, how we're going to do this, we're going to hold shift, press sequencer to get into the pattern mode. We're going to hold parameter minus, and let's say this time I want to clear pattern number 2. Now notice that it's already chosen pattern number 2 for me, so I don't have to do anything further than that. I'm gonna press the sequencer button one more time. Now what I'm gonna do is select my kick drum. Again, it's this first pad over here as I hold shift. And I'm gonna program a kick drum on every downbeat. I'm gonna switch to a different instrument, maybe let's say a closed hi-hat. Then I'm gonna hold shift, select the open hi-hat now, and I'm gonna put the open hi-hat on what we call every upbeat. I'm gonna put a 1, 2, 3, 4. And then what I can do is layer snares and hand claps over the beat to make it thump. I'm gonna now click the second pad while I'm holding shift to get my snare drum. More rim shot, because why not? maybe I want to sprinkle some hand claps across the beat. So I'm going to go back, hold shift, press this pad right here. So I've given you two basic examples of how to program a beat. Go ahead and experiment and figure out what works for the music that you spin.